So you'd like to learn how to use a palette knife to paint something like this? Coming up. Hi again there guys, Emma here from Paint and Pinot, giving you some top tips for all things art and design. And today we're going to look at how to paint this beautiful tertiary painting using a palette knife. If you'd like to see the original video which goes with this painting, which was the inspiration behind this, I will leave a link below. Alright, so today we're going to do a step-by-step guide and we're going to look at just a couple of tricks so that we can use making your palette knife a little bit easier. Here we go. So these are the two palette knives we're going to be using today. They're very different in shape. This is my go-to palette knife. It's got a much longer length, but we're also going to use a smaller palette knife today because it gives a little bit more fine detail. We're also going to be using an impasto gel. This is the impasto gel we're going to be using today. I find that if you add impasto gel, it just helps to really get that gorgeous thick quality to your acrylic paint. Otherwise, you're going to end up spending a lot more money on using more acrylic paint. There is a video which I'll link below where I actually use some cheats on how to create cheaper versions of impasto. But for today, this is the model we're going to be using. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is actually just practice a couple of techniques. The style we're going to be looking at really is based on an impressionist style of artwork. So if you think back to the famous Monet paintings, Monet was very much an artist who was fascinated by light, and a lot of his colors would really be quite vivid on the page.
Monet.
Do you know his work?
Of course. Look at his use of color here, isn't he great?
I know, it's extraordinary.
Alright, so the first thing we do, we've got a little bit of impasto which I've just mixed into here. I actually like to mix my colours on the page, so before we do that, we're just going to get used to doing a couple of techniques. So if you imagine your palette knife being like a butter knife, where you're actually buttering your toast, so you're simply just going to get used to putting the paint on and then basically merging it around. I'm going to add a little bit of colour to this so you can actually see. The white might make it a little bit more difficult. The beauty with palette knives is that you really have a lot more control than you think. So if I'm making a nice green here, the great thing I love about this is, let's say you make a mistake, you can literally scrape it off. All right, we don't want to do that today. One of the main mistakes I often see people doing as well with palette knives is they try to blend too much, or they keep going in the same direction. What we want to do is actually have a lot of variety, because you'll notice here now I've got a really gorgeous mint green going on, but that's not what I want. I want to be able to see the different colours. So actually what I would have done is I'd have taken my blue, taken my warm yellow, and then we'd have just mixed those in. You can see the difference now, you get all that lovely variety and texture. It's a little bit more impasto in there. Obviously using the impasto, you're going to add an opaque whitey mixture to it, so you just need to bear that in mind, so you don't overmix your colours. The other texture I wanted, or the other technique I'd like to look at today is trying to get fine detail, because we're going to be doing trees. So we need to be getting some trunk details going on into our paintings. So what I'm going to do, always handy to have a cloth handy so you can wipe off your palette knife nice and clean. I'm just going to load up my brush now. I'll just make a dark green. And all I'm going to do is simply line up this edge of the palette knife, so that when we put it onto the page, you can really get those lovely, gorgeous, detailed lines, like so. Load up a little bit more pigment. So on this page here, I'm just showing you how I would have mixed my paint. I always have my main pot of paint, which I just use an old plastic plate, and then I like to mix on just a piece of paper, so I can really practice the techniques I'm going to be using. So you'll be doing this kind of technique to get the tree lines working through. All right, I'm happy with that now, guys. I think we're going to start doing the actual painting. Here we go.
Thank you.
Guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video on how to produce this really simple but effective and beautiful palette knife painting. If you'd like to see where the inspiration for this painting came from, then I'll leave a link just below where you can get to see how I go outside or I get some inspiration to get some new art ideas. If you have enjoyed today's video, guys, then please do hit that like button just below, as it really does help our channel. And if you'd like to see some more regular top tips, then we do weekly videos, so do hit that subscription button just below. All right, guys, that's it for today. We'll see you next time. Happy painting.